Good morning, and today is the day two of my pregnancy stage bleeding, and tinatama talaga ako bumango kasi ang dami-dami ng dugo talaga, and di ko na alam ang gagawin ko. I'm so tired at hindi ako kumain. Kaninang gabi, hindi ako kumain. Tinatamad ako kumain talaga. Dahil na, dinudugo talaga ako. Ang dami ng dugo. The pregnancy miscarriage bleeding is getting worse, and I'm so tired right now, and I don't wanna wake up in the morning because my body is so painful and my back is so painful, like it's so painful, and everything now, my muscle is so painful and the blood is all over now, and it's non-stop bleeding, and I'm so scared. But this is happening to me every time. This is the 4 times that I got the miscarriage, and this is not new to me that I had a miscarriage, and this is the 4 times. Before, when I got a miscarriage, the bleeding takes 5 months straight before the pregnancy bleeding stop. Like, it's so intense bleeding for straight 5 months, and I cannot walk, and I just lay down in the bed for 5 months, and I'm not going out for 5 months because when I walk just one step and the blood is popped out, bleeding all over, and I cannot do a heavy work inside the house because the blood is flowing all over like that. And right now I'm so scared now because the blood right now, it's the same with my previous miscarriage happening to me, and I'm so tired about this kind of miscarriage. And my husband did not talk about anything about my miscarriage right now, and he said that, okay, you're bleeding, you miscarriage, it's okay, it's happening now, and move on, like that. But I don't need the advice of my husband behind this miscarriage, or dahil nakunan ako. Kung ayaw niyang pakialam ang nangyayari sa akin, wala akong pakialam. Sa totoo lang, ang asawa ko, pagdating sa miscarriage talaga at pregnancy stage, hindi ko siya maasahan kasi starting from the day one, I did not feel anything about the courage of being concerned about what happened to me or what I'm going through this kind of situation. Parang hindi ko nararamdaman yung simpatsya niya para sabihan ako na okay, na-miscarriage ka, nag-bleeding ka, it's done, like that, di ba? Kasi kung hindi ka concerned sa pregnancy stage ng asawa mo, di wag mo nang tabihan sa gabi, di ba? Para tapos na. Kasi I feel it from the day one of this kind of situation that parang wala akong nakukuwang concern or simpatya or parang concerned citizen about what happened to me because maybe I'm a targeted individual, and these people hurting me through emotion or push me to do like a sad situation, because even in the day one of Kahit noon pa, bata pa ako, pagdating talaga sa mga sakit, lagnat, punta hospital, ganyan, wala talaga akong simpatya or concern na nakukuha sa mga taong nakapaligid sa akin. I'm so emotional lang talaga. Nalulungkot lang talaga ako. I'm very dramatic right now kasi, pag ako kasi nagkaganito ng situation, I did not feel any sympathy about my relatives or my friends or even the neighbor that near to me on what happened to me. Pero pag sila, pag may nangyari sa kanila, as in yung buong kamag-anak nila, nagre-rest back agad, nagnire-rescue sila or ginagawan sila ng paraan para hindi sila malungkot or hindi sila umiyak. Pero pagdating sa akin, nag-iisa lang ako. Walang nakakaramdam ng feelings eh. Yung pakiramdam ko talaga. And punong-puno na ako eh. Punong-puno na talaga ako. Pang-apat na nangyari to. And kung ano man nangyayari sa akin, behind this sadness situation, magtago ka na. Sobra-sobra mo na akong sinasaktan sa mga bagay na alam mo sa sarili mo na wala akong ginagawang mali at hindi ko kaya magsinungaling at magtago sa buong mundo. So, ayun lang. I don't need the sympathy of other people. I don't need the advice or I don't need the kindness that you show me right now on what I'm going through to me through this miscarriage situation. And I'm so emotional because this is the fourth times that happening to me this kind of situation. But no matter what happened to me, I'm not stopping on what happened to my daily basis or daily life. I put you through this kind of situation because I did not accept. Hindi ako tumatanggap ng pagkatalo. Lalaban ako, hindi mo ako maisama sa pagiging childish emotional situation mo. So, ayun lang ha. Yun lang sinasabi ko. So, ayun lang. I just wanna share on what my feelings right now today, on what happening to my miscarriage, on this pregnancy bleeding, what happened to me. So, ayun lang ang masasabi ko talaga. Wherever you are, you're so lucky because all of the people put you in kinda respect situation. Unlike to me, the people around me judge me on what I am right now, even though they doesn't know who I am or who really I am. But no matter what happened to me, who cares about it? I just wanna expose it to YouTube. So, thank you so much to my viewers and my subscriber. Maraming salamat sa panunood nyo ng videos ko at sa pag-subscribe. So, ayun lang. Kanya-kanya tayo ng opinion, kanya-kanya tayo ng ginagawa sa buhay. So, ayun lang.